Hello all, this video is on installing Arduino code to ESP32 development board. The ESP32 development board is a powerful IoT board of the future. The ESP32 chip is inside this WROM32 box along with all peripheral sensors. This development board is like Node MCU but very much power packed with integrated Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. For USB connectivity, CP2102 Silicon Labs IC is used and a 3.3 volt regulator is on board. There are two push buttons, enable and boot, provided to upload firmware. The pins are breadboard friendly. The ESP32 is built on a dual core Extensa 32-bit microcontroller and a 16 MB flash. It has built-in Bluetooth, both classic and low energy BLE. ESP32 supports Wi-Fi direct for peer-to-peer connection without need of access point. Ultra low power coprocessor for deep sleep support is also provided. ESP32 is power packed with hardware features. It has three SPA channels, one of which is used by the flash. It has I2C, UART, CAN controller, Ethernet, PWM, ADC and even DAC. Compared to its predecessor ESP8266, ESP32 has more GPIO pins, RAM and dual core. ESP32 can be programmed by using ESP-IDF or Arduino Core. We shall see how to install Arduino Core for ESP32. ExpressIF's official Arduino Core is hosted on GitHub. You can download the Git tool. Links are given in the description below. Before installing Git, you need to install Python. Visit the Python website. Download the 2.7 version of Python. The latest versions have some issues with the ESP32, so install 2.7 version only. While installing, select add python.exe to path. This one configuration is very important. You have to select add python.exe to path. It is under customization of Python. Select that and proceed with the installation. Click finish on completion. Now download the Git installer. Select the 32-bit or 64-bit installer according to your PC. Proceed with the Git installation. Accept all default settings. Do not change anything. Accept all default settings. And on completion, just click finish. Do not launch from this window. Just click finish. We shall launch the Git GUI graphical interface from the folder now. Right click Git GUI and then run as administrator. On the next window, click clone existing repositories. On the next window, you have to enter the source location and target directory. For the source location, you can copy and paste. The link is given in the description below. Control C to copy and then Control V to paste. This is the source location and target the directory is your Arduino path. For me it is C, program files, Arduino, and then hardware. Select this folder and then click on clone. You'll get an error. The target directory, you need to add the path expressif/ESP32, otherwise you will get an error. After the hardware, you just type in /expressif/ESP32. Now click on clone. Cloning will start and working directory will be created. It may take some time, be patient. Now it is creating working directory. Finally, you get the Git GUI window. Close this window as we will install from the new directory. Now browse to C, Program Files, Arduino, Hardware, and then the new folders expressif and ESP32. Under Tools, you see the Git application. Just double clicking won't install Git. You must run Git application as admin. This is very important. You have to run the Git application as administrator. Extensa ESP32 toolchain is being installed now. And you can see the new folder Extensa. This contains the toolchain required for Arduino Core. Now the installation is over and you see the new folder Extensa ESP32. Now plug in the ESP32 development board to USB of your PC and then open the device manager. Note the COM port allotted. This COM port will be visible only if you have installed CP2102 driver already. Note the COM port allotted and then fire up the Arduino IDE, the latest version. Under Tools, select the COM port allotted and then select the board as ESP32 development module, ESP32 DEV module. Programmer is USB ASP. And then from examples, open the Blink sketch. In the Blink sketch, you have to do one modification. The built-in LED is at GPIO2 on ESP32. So you have to define this pin. Include the statement on top of the code, #define. LED underscore built-in 2. Now click on upload. The sketch is being compiled and then starts uploading. This may take some time as compared to the regular Arduino sketch. Once the sketch is uploaded, you can see the built-in blue LED blinking on ESP32. Now let us see one Wi-Fi example. For checking these Wi-Fi examples, you have to install the Boards Manager ESP8266. Only if the Boards Manager is installed, you can see the Wi-Fi examples. Under Tools, set the board and COM port. Programmer is USB ASP, and from under file examples, go to the Wi-Fi and select Wi-Fi scan. These examples will appear only if ESP8266 is installed under Boards Manager. Upload the Wi-Fi scan sketch. Once uploaded, open the serial monitor. You can see the scan start and it will display all the surrounding SSIDs. The scan will go on continuously, repeatedly, and you can see the SSIDs. Thank you for watching.